wait, Willow, you haven't seen this game yet. Oh, that's right. Every time we played this, it's been late at night. Oh, Lurt, are you not feeling well? I hope you feel better. Sleep last night. It looks like you lost progress. Yeah, I did. Now we are, we got back to where we were, which is good. So, oh, that's right. We got, okay, so we did get eaten. That's right, just remind the stupid idiot guy. Run. Yep, basically. Yeah, hey, buddy. Hey, good morning. All right, so this is a adventure game similar, oddly enough, also a little bit to like Resident Evil and Danganronpa, or not Danganronpa, Dead Man Wonderland. Yeah. In we go. Actually, if I go to the right, where does this go? Ooh, there's a goodie over here. Oh, nice. There's a clipping from a society. Oh, hang on. That's actually slightly desynced. Let me fix that real quick. Here we go. Cool. There's a clipping from a society magazine. Was the recent funeral of the heiress of the Sintra fortune part of a cover-up? Unofficial sources seem to believe so, as they've been unable to access the autopsy report so far. Ah, so head cold. Well, Lurt, hopefully you feel better. Last night, if you guys didn't know, we got eaten by a wall that was trying to seduce us, being like, don't you want me to lick you? This time, at least I won't take any damage. I should have noticed that, though. I really should have. I didn't. All right, there. She's gonna go over here. Let's welcome him, guys. He signed a terrible contract. Oh, crap. Damn it. She's going for the loogie. Oh, let's go for the loogie and the size T's. My brain goblins today and just relaxing. Yep, that sounds like a good idea, my friend. All right, let me go ahead and get a little bit of sneakers. Get sick on your day off. That's usually how it works, right? Like, you work, go through, or you get ready to do like a major event, like, I don't know, scream or stream, and then either you get sick or your dumbass gets like an impact the ear so you can't hear on the one side. We operate and we work with how we do. I don't know. Oh, that's right. I know how to handle you. I know how to handle you. I don't know why you're in your undies, but I know how to handle you. Oh, whoa, what is that? Uh-huh. Welcome, Hunter. Come closer. I was waiting for you. Do you want me to kiss you? What's the matter? Haven't you been kissed? I'll make a man out of you. Isn't that what you came for? No. That thing, not right. It's giving me a very bad feeling. I shouldn't go near it. I gotta find the marketing girl. Get out of here. I see. You don't even want to talk to me. Are you shy? Or are you afraid of me? Is it that the company hires cowards as hunters now? I love it. He's just like, excuse me, bitch, you just did not. Are you the witch? Ooh, sorry. So Fu is not gonna go for me now. Ooh, sorry, SJ. I'm just a friend who wants to help you. What kind of help? I have a clue. A clue about her. You don't believe me. Look. Look. Oh, just feel. It's a very important clue about the witch's identity. Come close if you want to take it. I can't quite see what it is from here, but it looks like a photograph. I've got it. It's perfect. What? What else is it gonna be? A slogan for my resume. Do resumes have slogans? Sure. One could get one. How could you get here without one? With the number of resumes they have to read every day in the human resources, the most important thing is the first sentence, the initial slogan. I have a perfect one. Take a look at it. Lick me and let me explode inside your mouth. Yep. Mm-hmm. It's perfect, don't you think? It's, maybe I wouldn't have... I mean, it's a bit direct, right? And do you know what? You didn't even know resumes should have slogans, bumpkin. Hi. No, the delicious mouth doesn't want to taste me. That thing on the wall? You really want her to eat you? Good question. Isn't that what we all want? The pleasure of being desired, getting recognition from your company, promotion? Pat on the hat, head, and then licked? By the mouth. But the mouth doesn't love us all equally. Some of them are savored for a while, and then she spits them out. She didn't even spit on me. No hakaloogie. But I can't give up. They say there's a way to trick her. There's an object, a magical symbol that she can't resist. Symbol. Some say it's a figure of voodoo magic. If you wear it, she'll notice you, she'll want you, she'll pull you in. But if you don't have it, she can't see you, she doesn't love you. That makes me very sad because she doesn't love me. Other than the impacted year, I've been good, Jeff. Yeah. Are you nervous because of your resume slogan? Yeah, how'd you know? No more slogans, just be yourself. Do you think the mouth will like it? Sounds simple, straightforward, and different. I'm convinced. I'm sure the mouth will like it. Yeah, but what if she doesn't like it? I can't risk looking like an idiot in front of my coworkers. Says the man in his undies. All right, carefully get close, but not too close, because she will literally vacuum cleaner my ass up. It is terrifying. Okay, so we can't leave without the photo, because we tried it last night. But we can't get close. No more marketing. just be yourself. Yeah, it's cheese, $5 says. I don't think that's cheddar. Okay, so, really sorry in advance, but I'm gonna wedge this on you. I'll put this on your belt. Forgive me for doing this to you. I hope you're not to the taste of that wall thing. Ooh, wait for it, wait for it. Help me, help me, help me. There we go, got it. You think you're smart, don't you? I got the photo. This picture must be important. Oh my God, the parents sold their soul to the devil. They had two daughters then. They had Cintra right there who they turned into a robot. And then their other daughter, they turned into a witch? Which also, oddly enough, looks like a Ninetales fox? Who could these people be? The best thing is to take it to Cintra, but before that, I'll have to get the marketing girl back. Alright, you wanna come with me? Go away if you want, Hunter. Go back to that stupid girl and take your trophy. I assure you, we meet again very soon. I'll end up giving you that kiss when you least expect it. Girls, please escort him out! And we're gone. If you're wondering, is this a weird game? Yes, it is. Boy, hey, buddy. I love he's just like, whew, finally got out. I hope those things can't get out of here. If you're wondering why is that woman crawling on the ground, apparently it's a form of yoga and marketing. Yes, it's so that you can get exercise while working. Well, here's the last one. Ah, thank you very much, Brian. Please, workmate, would you mind getting back to the others? It's a very weird game. This is like if they did Umbrella Corporation and then like threw in dark comedy and humor and then like made a little anime out of it. Oh, Brian, I owe you big time. Without you, I wouldn't have been able to handle everything. No problem. Don't worry about it. You taught me the trick to hiding properly. silly. That was nothing. You've helped me with my task. It's only fair that I help you with yours. What were you going to do on this war? You told me something about a horse, didn't you? Ah, yeah. It was nonsense. Motivational talk, homework, nothing important. Tell me, please. I want to help you. Well, I was asked to come to this war to make a friend. And, well, I thought maybe, we're friends, right? And they're coming out. Oh, shit! Find that hunter. Don't let him leave here with a photograph. I gotta go. Oh, no! Quick, let's hide. Yes. They told me they always leave their office at the end of the month, but it's too early. I don't understand. It's probably because of me. It's me. Wait, Jeff, it's not the stuff that you make at home, is it? Or did you buy it? Looks like they're gone. James, you gonna try this? Try what? Well, I think I better get back to my office. I have to get something important to a workmate. Okay, I still have a lot to work to do around here, but later I'll buy you a cup of coffee for everything you've helped me with. Oh, stuff you made at home, nice. All right, I'll see you later. Brad Super. I do not know why your luck is so good right now, but okay. All right, careful. Get to the door. And we are at it. Wooko! Oh! Oh, am I gonna try the crawling on the floor? No, I'm usually good without the crawling on the floor, you know? Who do I... Actually, let's go to Sintra first. Yeah. Sintra? Sintra's disappeared again. Where could she be? I don't know. Let's go find her. Ooh, sorry, Willow. She might be on the swing set again. Not on the swing set. Wait, what does that go? Uh-oh. Should we be in here? Oh, hey, Sintra. Helps with the yoga. Okay. Hi, Brian. What's all this? I didn't know there was anything like that this on the Sintranet. It's a digital library. The company has a collection of more than 10,000 books and articles. I like to spend my free time scanning and debugging the material. I was just now analyzing in detail that Hexen Hammer you brought me earlier. It's a fascinating book. Did you know that to close the deal with the devil, witches have to drink his blood? Ugh. Speaking of which, I think I found a clue. You found this. Where did you find it? I went to human resources on the fourth floor and there was a giant mouth on the wall. She said she was my friend and wanted to help me hunt down the witch, but she also wanted to lick me to death, so you know. I mean, I have like a robot voice, which would be like,
hello, how are you?
What? You told her you were a hunter? No, I didn't tell her anything, but she already knew. I don't know how to put it, the words, but I felt like I was talking to the witch. Everything about her gave me chills. Analyzing photograph. With his movie idea, and you would totally enjoy our recent topics. We're talking about torture and killing devices. Okay. Are you trying to find something for the movie, or just in general? Do you know who they are? Yes, it's the Sintra family. Sintra Corp was created in 1951 by Sintra, in the photo, besides the patriarch, his wife, Zhao Ying. His daughter, Ray Sintra, up here. You have a certain resemblance to her, don't you? That's correct. According to company records, Ray Sintra died at the age of 11. The family was so saddened that when I was made, they wanted to honor her memory by making me in her image and likeness. Are we sure it's not you just in general? Like, they pull the Keanu Reeves, like, uploading your ass to the Matrix? Some different ideas. Ah. So, who's the person with the burned face? Because of her high interest, she could be another girl of similar age, but I'm sure the family didn't have any more descendants. It's possible she's a friend of Ray's, but it's impossible to identify her from this image. She has Neko ears. It can't be that hard. Do you think talking to someone in the family might help? That's a great idea, but I'm afraid there's no one left alive. The last relative of the Sintra family died in 1983. I guess I can relax a little bit and look for the other clues in the canteen. There's one thing I don't understand. Why did the witch give you this picture? Well, she didn't really give it to me, and more like sacrifice somebody who she spat out. She used it as a trap to get me to approach her so she could attack me. I managed to trick her and get the picture. We don't know if it might be another trap, but at the same time, it's the best lead we have. It's a tired one, and they got around to dominating everyone. You're trying to come up with things that we don't see. Ah, okay. Brian, you need to get the information on the Sintra family. We need to find out who that other girl is. But how? You just said they're all dead. The remains of the Sintra family are stored on the 8th floor. Head over there and try to find what you can. Oof. Well, okay. It means, yes, I'm gonna go check it out. I know what it means, Brian. But I notice a change in your attitude. You're being pissy. You told me you went to Human Resources, didn't you? Huh? What were you doing there? Oh, yeah, well, I was helping Kate, a partner for the Hive. Is she your girlfriend? What?
Nani?
No. She's my girlfriend. Not my girlfriend. She's someone I met in the lobby this morning. Today is her first day, too. I know what you're gonna tell me, and no, I haven't told her anything about being a hunter. I didn't tell anyone, okay? Sintra family, where did you say I had to go now? 8th floor. Okay. So, what's the deal with the guy and the horse? I went to the motivational meeting, and oh my gosh, that guy's got all out of it. The guy's out of his mind. After everything else today, I don't think I can even... I'm surprised. These meetings have been organized to boost your productivity and emotional worth within the company. Just so you know, he set me a task. Supposedly, I have to make a friend on the 4th floor. Then I ask you to prioritize the elimination of the witch. Motivational tasks are not mandatory. Don't forget that we hired you. Don't forget what we hired you for. Oh, yes? You called me Brian before, and now you've called me Mr. Pasternak again. Probably. Sorry about the mistake. No. Call me Brian, please. That sounds like my father. On the outskirts, the first name is always used for young people, not the surname. Debugger, as you wish, Brian. Came up with a human centrifuge, a giant capsule that maybe 8 or so people go in. You mean like a circus ride, Lord? Sounds a little like a circus ride, but yeah, I get it. All right, let's go up to floor eight. Okay, so what's on floor 8 exactly? I can't quite remember. Oh, it's the park. Hello? Who could notice things like these? The goblin likes to smoke as much as he likes cheese. Yes, the goblin liking cheese just... Mm-hmm. No, it wasn't for playing with fire or for staring at screens. You'll find that the goblin saw the witch so many times that he went blind. Okay, so if you look at the witch, you go blind. They're strapped down and then spun around. Nope, it's not. You know the thing that separates your blood cells, white cells, and platelets? Yes. Having something like that. So, what, does it separate their fluids from their organs? Or just their brains from their bodies? And or eyes? Oh. This looks like a cemetery. a big rusty lock on this gate. I don't think I can get through without the key. Sorry. Also, Gratia. I think I know where the witch is. It says, since your family cemetery, 1894 to 1983, in memory of a poor family that became most important in Capital City, may evil never follow you here, and may you rest in peace. Aw, that never happened. Nobody, Yugi. Shockingly, nobody died, and I love it. We got real lucky, too. Where did all the smog come from? It smells like burning. I think the only person that technically died was Josh, because he became a Wendigo. It turned up into mush, and the liquids go down a tube, are collected in, and turn power of the city, and is a part of food for people. Ah, the good old Soylent Green Lord. All right, so they like cheese.
Okay.
Damn it. Use? No. I think if I duck into the bushes, nobody will be able to see me. All right, where's the bushes? At the tree. Where's the... Okay, so I can now hide in the shrubbery. I am Solid Snake. Go. And 2 packets of coffee. Awesome. Am I okay? Other than the impacted ear galactic? Yeah. Also, hi, by the way. Morning. Hope you have a good day. Ow. Damn it. Drinking mead with chili peppers. Does that... I mean, that's probably got a nice little spicy afterkick, right? Ooh, that is a naked man in a boat. Okay, wait a minute. Why is there a naked man in a boat? Oh, I see what I have to do. These are all gonna float, don't they? We all float down, chat. We all float down. All right, they lose me here, and then I run down. Go float too. Hey. Somebody's gotta float somewhere, man. Somebody's got to do it. Thought about a check in this fire and drink some for me. I have not had that, but to be fair, I'm actually not much of an not much for alcohol. Hi, buddy.
No. No one knows the past of this madman, I avow. The goblin was controlling, obsessive, and ambitious until not long before now.
Okay. You gotta find this game is really weird, chat. Huh? Why are you playing these weird-ass games? This one... I picked, and actually I'm really happy with this one. You need to have tea? Did I tell you I'm actually... I have my, coffee mug showing up here soon. Which, eventually, I will be able to showcase on the stream. Be very happy. Also have, some Bigelow Steep green tea coming. Oh, that stuff's so good. If there is a fire, burn witch paper. Wait. Serious? It's a bonfire, but I can't see anyone around here. Let's burn one of the witch papers. Does that save? No. Oh, I appreciate that, Jeff. To be fair, I used to drink when I was younger, but... And when you have kidney stones as a result of alcohol, you just don't want them. Like, you really don't. If you've ever popped out a kidney stone and or something larger, much larger, like a baby, kind of get the idea. Who's there?
I'm the one who likes to smoke as much as he likes.
Jeez.
I'm the one who is blinded by the witch. I'm the one who is invisible because,
you use magic from consuming driven society of common folk. You're wearing a... Aww, crap, I screwed that up. Okay, let me get the screwdriver here. It wraps around. Nice. All right, hold up. We're gonna save just in case then. Kidney stones are way worse than having a kid. Really? I don't know. My sister looked at me. She's like, "You have kidney stones." Yes. Like, not fun to have. I'm gonna save it just in case. See, normally I'm not. Originally, I wasn't really much of a tea drinker. But somehow, the second I came across, like, the Bigelow green tea, oh my god, like, it's the steep tea. It's not their standard one. It's the steep one that they just came out recently. And, like, I don't know, that stuff's, like, just so damn good. What happened? Hey, it's Hugo the Ass! Scream Death Row to Canada. Well, this is actually from the guy behind, I think it's Lucanor Lurit, which is essentially about a little boy who finds himself lost in the woods, finds a mansion, and then is asked by a demon, like, to get help. But then, of course, the demon's trying to trick the kid into giving his soul away. And I remember we played it, like, 2 years ago, and the ending was just absolutely gut-punching. Like, I walked away from the stream and cried, and then came back. I'm like, okay, guys, here we go. Okay, let's try this again. Jeez. I am the one who is invisible because... There we go. Now, I'm a madman, but I was... Controlling, aggressive, and arrogant. Controlling, obsessive, and ambitious. Hellblade is fantastic, by the way.
Holy shit, dude, your eyes!
Pass away, just seems like you're a different person. Really? I would almost say super, it's just imagine a matter of like being more comfortable with who I am versus feeling like I had to either be more like,
and now this.
Yeah, I used to lay up on quite a bit as a kid. The youth that I was had, F on this, F on that. Yeah, but I was a foul boy, I'm sorry. Dark hair doesn't suit me. You mean my fake dark hair? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's just one of those things where, I will be honest, streaming has allowed me to kind of get to know who I am, to really figure out who I am. Because at one point when I was younger, I knew, and then due to life experiences, sort of lost my way, kind of found myself back, you know.
Good to see a horror movie?
Yeah, actually, if you haven't seen it, Ready or Not, I remember, Lure, I hit you up on that. Did you guys see Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark?
A creature with two bellies.
Hello. So, my name is Pasternak?
I saw that, Jeff, you cheeky old bastard.
Play Magic the Gathering sometime? I tried playing that in high school. I haven't played that since, Yugi. You have? Okay. Also, you got a new teddy bear. Nice. If you like tea, I recommend Adagio? Jeff, if you could you put a link in Discord if you're in our Discord? That way I can take a look at it later. I should play Stellaris. Yeah, I saw that. That does look pretty good, Galactic. It's a new online game. I was watching Zeke play a little bit of that a few months back. Ah, Pastor Inuik. I'm sorry, but who are you then? Do you live here in that hair? You're invincible. And your eyes. Oh my, you don't have eyes. You. You're gonna kill me. You have not. Oh, you haven't. Either people have been sick or TwitchCon. I can see that. Calm down. Garma, Mr. Pastis. You ask me a lot of questions like that, you look goofy. You have to take your life with a soup. Spoonful of sugar. Okay, in these dark times, the human being is a slave to time. Everything is important. That's urgent. Run. I catch you! Enjoy the moment, old friend. Like me, here under a tree with my cigar and a nice piece of cheese to while away the afternoon. The paradise of the yum-yum. Oh my god. Okay, wait a minute. The paradise of the yum yum. Feel like,
Chat, do you have the paradise of the yum yums?
If you say so, then, say so? Who are you then? Ah, well, I think I'm an employee of the mega corporation called Centerport. Not really sure. I lost my memory a few months ago when I went completely mad. I don't remember my mother or my name either, but your fellow government officials call me the Forest Goblin. Although I'm not a forest, and this place isn't a real goblin. I think I like this guy. Also, grats. They have fandom tees? What do you mean by fandom tees? Show I was watching on Amazon called Lore. Haven't seen it. I did actually start watching the new Stephen King movie on Netflix called Tall Grass or something. So far, it's actually been pretty good. If you like the actor who plays in The Conjuring, the husband, Conjuring 1 and 2, he's actually in this one. And what are you doing here? What do you do?
I do magic with products.
Magic. Yeah, with barcodes. What? When I removed myself from the office, I took refuge in this lonely yard and began to perceive the magic that surrounds the manufactured objects of our consumer-led society. As the old Etruscan proverb says, only when you walk away from the lights of the big city can you see the stars at night. Equally and of different sizes, all the secrets of the products were revealed to me. Secrets of the products. Yes, and their barcodes. I don't understand anything you say. Etruscan. Ah. Magnificent. Then demonstrate what you're saying, Mr. Paston Bunaku. But if you don't have any barcodes? Or some Mr. Packaging of some product you don't need? Well, I have an empty cereal box. Does that work? Aha! All right. Cereal boxes are super powerful. The most powerful breakfast. Well above waffles or croissants. Yeah, I give him the cereal box. Probably creative, Yugi, if you can. Or, Lavi. They have Critical Role tea blends. That's what you mean, Jeff. Okay. Huh. And they're pretty decent? Made barcodes. That's this huge, nice Xmas house. Like, barcodes for a living lord? Let me lick his barcode a little bit. You recommend them? Linked? Thank you, Yugi. Aha. I see. This code corresponds to the magic of poisonous gas. What? Ooh, wait a minute. Do I have to put that on my head? That contract you see lying on the stone will allow you to breathe in toxic environments full of farts. Wait, I'm sorry. That's a methane buildup? I mean, yes, we've been playing a lot of Oxygen Not Included, but hot damn, I can make you a copy if you give me 2 witch papers as hostages. Ah, death has come. I almost forgot to tell you, I also sell blank witch papers. He invented the Bargo and the system he scans it to? Oh. This game is weird. I suppose you know, don't you? I sell them for 10,000 credits each. Damn, dude! Even though I've got them reduced by 50%, so they'd be 1 slice of cheese each. Magic contracts? Can you explain me the magic contracts again? Got it. Cemetery. Do you know anything about the cemetery back there? It's where the witch lives. What? Is that true? No. No? Noise. No, yes? Please, this is important. I pushed the gate and I heard a scream, and I think I saw something or someone. Would she be the witch? I don't know! Well, make up your mind. Okay, somehow, I don't know why, but I'm like getting a little bit of like Monkey Island with this game. I love it. Is it true what they say that you saw the witch? I don't want to talk about it. Oh, sorry. I saw the witch 8 times. It always happened the same way. First, anxiety. You want to run away and you don't know why. Second, the lights go out and you feel the air get thick around you. A weight on your shoulders. Third, the hiss that sticks like a pin in your ear. And a kiss. Followed by sexual assault. Or harassment, sorry. A kiss? Like someone's kissing your cheek. At first, I tried to hide or run like the others. Then I stopped and was like, man, that was a good kiss though, so like, yes. What's the weirdest game I played? Me? Let me think on that alert. Forest Play follows. She just wants a sexy time. I'm hearing Entitled Goose Game is about like 6 hours of pretty good. She didn't really want to kill me. She was just torturing me. She always made the comrades around me disappear. She left me alive. Every time I saw her, it drove me crazier and crazier. I gouged my eyes out the last time she visited me and I came to live here. Wait. You gouged your own eyes out. I haven't seen her since. And you never knew who she was? Nope. If I knew, I wouldn't forget. I always thought that. I don't know. It could be anyone. kind of like this guy. Wait a minute. I have the cheese. Yes. Cheese is valuable. You've signed the protection contract against poisonous gas. Therefore, we could go back and walk through the heavy, heavy methane jet. Yes. Which I feel like might be a good idea, too. Is awesome. I'm a little worried, well, a smidge worried that Goose Game might be one of those games where it's more like a meme game, not like a game. Makes any sense? How far am I in Oxygen Not Included? Well, I haven't played recently, like the past like day or two. So I really wouldn't say that far. Holy crap! Oh, damn it. Well, damn, chat. Okay. Nothing interesting. Do I have any pencils? I got one pencil. That's right. Ooh, ink cartridge, grab some water. You know, I should probably just empty them out, now that I think about it. Does that go back up? Yeah, that goes back up. Yeah, this game's weird. I love how this is just a methane buildup. That's all it is. Ooh.
Blar, flar, blar, blar, flar.
Ew, sorry, dude. Can I get you like a Pepto? Oof. I mean, I'm not gonna shank the man with a pencil, chat. Like. Damn it, is there no way to get to get past his pukey? Okay, gotta go. Ooh, actually, no, I don't think I can toss water at him. Yeah, I don't think I toss water at him. All right, so let me go back up here. Now, was there any, like, methane buildup around here? So we have to go up here. Well, I mean, he's just an innocent-ish man. Who is it's like when you get dog farts, okay? When you get dog farts, you just get really sick, okay? Exactly what he's going through right now, right? And I cannot fault the man for dealing with something like that. I'm trying to remember, where's the canteen? I think the canteen's on what floor again? Oh, actually, hang on. We can go to Human Resource, and I should be able to talk to our buddy over here. Not you. Oh, this is security. Where's IT? I want to go talk to Dashi. Initiation canteen. We got to go to floor one. And then we go back up to... Actually, no. He should be over here then. He might have some... Hey, buddy. Hello, Dashi. Oh, hey, yeah. Sure. Put it over there. What? Oh, hello. Hi. What's up, dude? I came to see what you were doing around here. You're taking a stroll around the company, aren't you? Well, welcome to the electronic garbage paradise, buddy. Here I fix a little bit of everything. Computers, printers, cell phones. I also like to collect components for, well, modifying things or, you know, do my experiments. But hey, that's a secret. You work alone? No one helps you? Yeah, well, there used to be more, but between this and that and work-related accidents are the order of the day. You know what I mean, don't you? Yeah, perfectly. Just baptize them? Yeah, just... Especially, you know, dog farts. That's how you help them. I don't much work, actually. Around here, the crowd can't tell a turned on computer from a turned off one. I've had orders accumulated for years, and no one says a word. So I mind my own business. This company is chaos. I don't know how it's still going. I have a theory that's going to drive you crazy. Want me to tell you? Sure, tell me. First of all, get all that old witch stuff out of your head. We're old enough not to go around believing in fairy tales. Look, this is very simple. This company's a machine, and the parts that make it work are the employees and all that. You follow? Sort of? For example, imagine that the company is a printer you have at home. One day, it prints out two sheets of paper together. Another day, it misprints some data. The next day, it swallows paper. Mixes the files you send to the print. You know, the typical printer spoofs. Uh-huh. You know that damn thing is freaking out. It's broken or something. And you call your buddy, Dashi, to keep an eye on it and fix it for you. Awesome. But dude, what if there's no owner? If only the printer exists, who says it's broken? All their parts are working. They take paper, they print. They may work oddly, but they work. And that's what's happening to this company. It's broken. It's corrupt. But at the same time, it's still working. Follow me? How are you holding up? Well, while you're recovering from...